Now, Philippine shares managed to see a second weekly gain last week despite concerns over the peso's weakening against the U.S. dollar. The main index, however, closed lower on Friday with traders bracing for the latest MSCI rebalancing, which takes effect by the end of the month. Now, this morning, the PSE opened lower at 66.08. That's lower by 0.2% or 0.2%, that is. And joining us this Monday morning, we have Chris Mangan of mangan.com. Hi, Chris. Welcome to Market Edge.
Good morning, Stanley. Thank you for having me on the show.
It's good to have you here. Now, you've seen some reports about confidence in the U.S. markets, although today they're a bit upbeat there. But really, it is still expected to tick lower in May at 95.9 versus 97 in April, with the last report already missing expectations by a big margin. Now, are you seeing confidence retreating further now that the Fed's turning more hawkish, Chris?
Well, in terms of confidence in equities, just specifically Philippine equities, I think there isn't a lot of excitement. There's not, investors are not looking as closely at these developments because they're not exciting enough. I mean,
yeah.
Basically, there's nothing exciting for investors to come in and to drive prices higher. And I don't think I mean, everybody knows that the economy is doing better and it's continuing to improve. Mm-hmm. However, we're not seeing that in our local shares.
Right.
It's different in the U.S. stock market, but here, there just isn't the same excitement. And I agree with most analysts that the way the market is moving right now, we're seeing the index move sideways, which basically means that prices are not moving in the same direction.
Okay.
However, there are individual issues that have good uptrends. So despite that, there are opportunities.
Okay. Chris, when you say you're moving sideways, it could still be in the upward or downward direction. What trend are you seeing right now for our market at this stage? Is it still trending up?
Well, I don't think we're going to see any big moves in the short term. Like I said, there's no excitement after they came out and after central banks decided not to cut rates, which was what everybody was waiting for.
Yeah.
I don't see any single external factor that's gonna affect prices in a positive way in the mm-hmm. immediate term.
Mm-hmm.
But that being said, there are individual issues that are still in strong uptrends.
Mm-hmm.
So just because prices aren't moving together, that doesn't mean that there aren't opportunities.
Okay. Now, Chris, it's different when you say there are no catalysts that could move this market at this stage, but also casting a lot of gloom in the market since last week was the further weakening of the Philippine peso against the U.S. dollar. Range for this week is now said to be at 58.50. I don't know if we're en route to the 59 to the dollar lows seen last year. How are investors pricing this in this week, and what are the expectations?
Yeah, for me, the currency movement is very interesting because right now it's trading at the levels we saw back in September of last year. However, last year, the dollar was much stronger than it is now. And so the correlation isn't there. Also with oil prices were higher during that time last year. And right now, it isn't. So this tells me that the dollar being stronger is because of speculation. So that's what they were talking about, that mm-hmm. the BSP was going to come in and try to tame
right.
that.
Yep.
Yeah, intervene mm-hmm. and try to keep speculation from getting the price to run away from them. So I don't think it's going to be interesting. I think they're going to keep it from getting any higher. It might stay here for probably a week or two. If it stays there longer, then it's going to be interesting.
All right. Maybe one can take advantage of this lull as well in the market to, you know, take a hard look at portfolios now. I mean, if one's portfolio did better in the first quarter, but, you know, somehow that investor failed to lock in profits when the market dipped. Now, is it wise to wait for stronger prices, or are you seeing that as something that may not happen in the near horizon, really?
I'm sorry, it kind of cut out there for a moment.
Yes, I was.
Could you repeat that?
Yeah. I was asking about some investors that may have made money in the first quarter of this year but failed to lock in profits when the market dipped. Now, is it wise to, you know, lock in profits still? Is this the highest that the market can achieve? Or, you know, are you seeing an option, hold and see if the market improves in near term, which you're saying doesn't seem to be happening?
Well, it depends on your strategy, really. If you're holding a bunch of issues broad, if you're holding a bunch of issues through different sectors, then and you have a long-term horizon, I see the prices going higher toward the end of the year. So maybe locking in profits right now or slight losses might not be too wise. But if you've already generated a good profit, of course, locking in those profits is a good idea. Mm-hmm. But that being said, also getting into those issues that have strong uptrend is still another option too.
Okay. Now, for the end of May, the month of May, we have, of course, the MSCI rebalancing. Covered this earlier. The highlights of which is AEVs out, while weights for issues like SM and Ayala Corporation have been reduced. Now, is it wise to take advantage of the current price weakness of these stocks now?
Well, of course. Anytime there's a good price on these big companies, this will attract investors. But AEV's been in and out of the MSCI
right.
over the last few years. So I don't think there's going to be any big excitement on it. But what I am tracking though is Leandro Leviste's playbook. I mean,
right.
If you want to make some money in this market now.
What do you make of that?
It's incredible. I mean, everything he's touched recently has turned to gold.
Okay.
So there's a lot of excitement on what he's doing. And if you're a trader who's active in the market, I mean, you just have to follow the money and what he's doing right now is good for investors.
All right. Lastly, Chris, you know, offer period for C-REC begins today, priced at 2 pesos and 70 centavos per share. Is the market excited about this IPO, and what are you seeing for C-REC?
Yeah, well, just based on the last IPO, I thought there would be more excitement because of high gold prices.
Yeah.
But the last IPO didn't draw that same excitement. I'm hoping that this one draws more excitement. Recently, AC Energy's stock has been in at least 3 to 4 weeks.
Uh-huh.
Maybe that will pour over into this Citicorp IPO. So, we'll just have to wait and see.
Yeah, we'll see. Anyway, Chris Mangan of ManganOnMarkets.com, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Have a great trading week ahead.
Thank you, Stanley. You have a good day.